Today's show is brought to you by Harry's. To get your free trial set, including a razor handle, five-blade cartridge, and shave gel, go to harrys.com/cadcast right now. That's harrys.com/cadcast. Ladies and gentlemen, what do I say? I already forgot.
Oh. Welcome to CADcast number 496. As always, I am your host, Wombat, here in Long Island, New York. And as always, I am joined by a man so shiny and bald that when he stands out on his porch, ships don't crash into the rocks on foggy days. GPD.
I had a massive brain fart there. I think it was caused by reading the ad and then having to go to something that I don't write down.
That's all right. I think I picked up the slack.
You did a fantastic job.
That's what I do. That's why you get me around.
Yeah, I like totally short-circuited there. And I even prepared an intro for you.
Hey, you know, one of those days.
Pondering
my mortality.
I was going to say, here's a man who's a winner in more ways than one, Wombat.
True. True, true.
And shipwreck.
What a lucky man I am. And shipwreck.
I'm here as well.
So congratulations, Wombat, on winning that big prize.
It was fun. I honestly did not expect that. So
you can't say that you never win anything anymore.
I know, which is true.
It's over.
My streak of losing is over, right?
Tell the people what you won.
I won 20 Xbox One indie games in a Twitter contest that I only entered because I don't even know why. I think I saw someone else retweet it, and actually someone actually mentioned, hey, you should enter this. This one's pretty good.
Hey, Wombat, you enter every contest on Twitter. Would you like to enter this one?
And I do, because, you know, I don't know why. I kind of get a little bit of an adrenaline rush when you hit that retweet to win.
Do you really?
Yeah, a little bit of like a gambling, it's why I don't go to Atlantic City. This is really why I shouldn't be allowed to gamble. Because I'd be like, yeah, I want to spin the wheel. Does a wheel spin? Where do I spin it? How do I spin this wheel?
So that's cool. Maybe we'll hear about some of the games that you won later in the show if you want to talk about.
Yeah, I played a couple.
Indie Corner for the next 20 weeks.
Exactly.
Where Wombat plays one indie game a week and talks about how much he loves indie games.
You never know. But no, it was cool and I appreciate it, and I should probably look up the name of the guy who I won all the prizes from.
Oh my god. You didn't even write that down?
I
really
didn't know that
bump here, Wombat.
I didn't know that Chibi was gonna like bring it up first thing.
No, well, this way, by not knowing, you can't be accused of winning because you have so many followers, and the guy would think that he would get publicity by making you win artificially.
Which I don't think he did. I'm pretty sure I just randomly picked my name out of a hat.
Well, you have no idea what will happen.
I don't know. I'm going to assume that because that's what that's what I hope. I wouldn't want to win otherwise, to be perfectly honest.
I'm going with Russian interference.
There you go. Randall Thor 19. That's RAND_AL_THOR_19 on Twitter. Thank you very much for the pretty awesome prize pack.
Well, now you gave him exactly what he wanted. The whole thing's a scam.
That's it. The fix is in. Fix is in. Everybody who paid money to enter that contest is out.
That guy is going to get literally tens of followers from that plug.
Exactly. So,
all of them pretty ladies.
Well, welcome to the show, everybody. We have, I'd like to say that we have a lot of big news to talk about this week, but that would be a lie, a dirty lie. But I do have a big update that I know a lot of people are waiting to hear about.
Are the rocks wet?
So wet.
How wet?
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to talk about smart sprinklers. Yeah, so I got my sprinkler system installed. And it's, I gotta say, it's pretty awesome. Yeah, it's, everything is now app controlled. You enter in different zones for the different parts of your garden, I guess, or
rock
lawn.
Zone.
Rocks are different. You actually enter in what kind of rocks you have and the size of the rocks and color. No.
Soft rock zone.
This thing is pretty amazing. You each zone, you really do enter in like what kind of, what you're watering, whether it's grass or shrubs or trees. There's no selection for rocks.
So you're just lying at that point?
it's all a lie. And it figures out how much shade that area, that particular area gets, and what kind of soil it is, and if it's on a slope, and so on and so forth.
So
and
if then, I stood on your lawn and was like, yeah, that's a lawn, it would know how much shade it's getting?
Wait, what? No. Sorry, that took me a moment. That was good, Wombat. Look at you.
Thanks. I'm glad that little joke grenade went off.
Yeah, I mean, it checks the weather forecast to see if it's rained enough to change the schedule that it's already put into place. I don't know. It's pretty cool. I admit that I buy some questionable items in the past, but this seems like pretty much a no-brainer, because if you have a sprinkler system like this, you need a sprinkler controller. And, you know, if you don't get the smart one, you're going to spend $100 anyway.
What was the order of events here, though? Was it that you found out that there was a smart sprinkler, or you were putting in a sprinkler system? Which came first?
Okay.
Scenario.
After last summer, where I tried to water the lawn myself by a combination of using a hose and then just dragging around a hose connected to sprinklers, I decided that I wasn't going to do that again because it took a lot of time. And even with a lot of effort and time put into it, I was still doing a very shitty job. Parts were not getting watered and the grass wasn't growing in certain parts. So I decided that I would eventually get a in-ground sprinkler system. And I sort of remember hearing about the smart sprinkler aspect of it and said, hey, let me see how much this costs. And it was just a negligible amount over the not a dumb sprinkler controller. So I went for the Wi-Fi jobby. And yeah, I no regrets so far. But it's rained a lot this week, so it hasn't gone on yet. So yeah, it's the people have asked which one it was. It's the Rachio, Rachio. I think I spelled
nice.
That right. I think I spelled
if
that
I
right.
If I was going to put a sprinkler system in, I would go with that one.
You don't have a sprinkler system?
No.
Well, how do you water your lawn?
I don't.
Oh, okay.
How does it stay green?
Ohio magic?
I guess.
No, really?
Yeah, because we had that drought last summer and it basically killed my lawn. So, I don't know.
I have a very full, lush lawn.
Yeah, well, how does
I've
that?
I've seen pictures.
It just rains a lot?
It rains sometimes.
Shit. I don't know. No, like all my shrubbery was getting brown.
Some of my neighbors have those sprinkler systems, but their lawn doesn't look any greener than mine does. So,
oh no, we definitely need it here. I don't think it rains enough, especially during the summer. Anyway,
are
so
I'm going to buy the newest smart device that just got announced.
the Amazon Echo Look.
Yes.
No.
I love your Amazon Echo. I love my Amazon Echo.
Me too.
I was excited that I got an email that said, like, you are exclusively invited to order the next Amazon Echo product.
Oh, I don't think I was invited.
I wasn't invited.
I have three of them. Hold on. Now I'm now I'm upset.
You should send a nasty note to Amazon and say,
oh, no,
I own three.
It doesn't say I was invited. It just is telling me about it. I still have to request an invitation. What's up with that shit? Anyway.
I don't know. I have two of them.
This thing.
Not
this,
the Amazon look or the Echo look. This thing is ridiculous.
Well, like, it's not for us.
It's such a strange product for Amazon. So it's, does it have all of the Echo stuff in there too? Or is it strictly just the camera part?
I'm pretty sure it's just a Look at My Wang product. No. That was this the original name.
They are only pushing it. Like the feature that they're pushing is that you can take pictures of your outfits daily.
I have a theory about this.
And this will post them somewhere?
Yeah. First of all, it is a regular Alexa in there as well.
Okay.
Oops.
My Alexa. I was waiting. Oh. I was waiting to hear that.
Yeah. It's so annoying. Sorry.
That's why I don't say Alexa during the show.
Right. Too late. I think my theory is they wanted to figure out a way to get a camera into one of these things and have the only way to do that without people getting all pissy about privacy and you know, rightfully so, is to give it a really specific purpose like this. And
that
I think
seems so overly specific, though.
Well, like, there's no rush, right? I mean, they don't need to.
So are we like, what, two iterations away from it being a Kinect? Like it just. The next one they come out with is going to have motion controls for whatever reason. Like, your lights will turn on as soon as you enter the room.
Well, that'd be good.
And then next thing you know, you have a Kinect.
I mean, it accomplishes two. Amazon does sell clothing and this thing. I don't know. It's not for us, so I'm really not spending too much time thinking about it.
Why are we still talking about it?
Shipwreck's very into style.
Tell me about your carpet.
So, okay, here's my other thing that I bought, and that, you know, like I said, sometimes I get made fun of for buying silly things, but Mrs. Cheapy was complaining that our carpet in our bedroom was smelling like feet. Probably my feet, I'm thinking.
because no one wears shoes in the house, and you don't have any pets.
Here's what happens. I know what happens. I know where the smell is coming from. I didn't
you
tell
you pee on your feet in the shower and you don't dry them properly.
No. I come home from table tennis and I'm very sweaty because I don't take a shower there. And, you know, not only did I play table tennis for an hour and a half, but I'm walking through Manhattan and I'm walking home from the train station. So my feet are pretty moist by the time I get home. I take my shoes off. My socks are probably not dry and not smelling that great. And then I eventually make my way to the bedroom and get into the shower. But, you know, there's some stink that's getting attached to the carpet, and it's a shag carpet. So it, you know, there's a lot of room for the stink to get embedded in there. So I was going to hire like Stanley Steamer or some company to come and clean the carpet. We only have two carpets. We have one in my bedroom and one downstairs in the den. So I was going to hire these guys, but then one day I was looking at the Best Buy deal of the day and it had some Hoover carpet cleaning vacuum on there for $100, and it got really good reviews. So I said, well, it certainly would cost me at least $100 to have these guys come over. So why don't I just buy this thing? And then I don't need to have anybody come into my house, which seems like a win-win. And I have to say, it did a fantastic job. It looks better. It does not smell like feet anymore. I got to look at the big container of dirty water that it produced from the cleaning. So I know that it did stuff. So I'm very happy. I'll tell you which one it was in case you want to keep an eye out for it. It was the Hoover Deluxe. Oh,
that sounds right.
It was the one that was like normally 130, and I think it was like $100. Here, wait, I'll tell you the exact one because I know that's very important to people.
It is very important.
We're still talking about this?
We also got a carpet cleaner, but I was not planning on talking about it on the show.
At the same time as I did?
A couple days before, yeah.
Wow, what's going on?
Cats are peeing.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't, I don't have a carpet cleaner. I actually recently threw away the rug in our living room.
I can't do that.
We just have wood floors right now. We're between rugs.
I think that my model is now sold out on Best Buy because it won't even let me look at it in my order history. So
it's how big of an influencer you are.
Right. I haven't even talked about it yet and people are already buying it. Anyway, that was a good buy. Two good purchases in the last week or so. The sprinkler system and the carpet cleaner. So I'm winning too, Wombat. You're not the only one.
Congratulations.
Thank you. How about some show feedback?
Sure. Repeatsky has to say, I love the awkward quiet when Wombat started talking about giving someone a Harry set. So glad GP and Chip called him out on regifting in a friendly, busting his chops kind of way. Reminded me of last year when he regifted his Father's Day set from Harry's.
I forgot about that.
My father liked it very much, so I don't care.
Right.
I also gave him other things. Ordered my own. I did. I had
Warby Parker glasses and HelloFresh.
Yeah, free box of HelloFresh. Exactly. You know me well. No, I gave him a mug and a t-shirt because that's pretty much what I give him every year. Here's a mug and a t-shirt. Mm. Ordered my own trial to support the CAG cast and was really surprised by the quality of the razor and the shaving cream. Go Harry's. Love the show and all of Wombat's cringeworthy moments. I.e. a grown man having month-long birthdays, which technically, remember, if you're going to send me a gift, tomorrow's your ship date deadline. So, seriously, people, get on it.
It's the big 4-0, everybody, so.
I mean, really.
Something.
If you're going to send me something, now's the time. Please, you don't have to send me anything. Jealousy anytime Shipwreck gets a review copy or anything else for free, his McDonald's swag, etc. Keep it up. I actually did get a box of swag this week.
From what?
From Lord of the Rings Online.
That's still a thing?
They sent me a 10-year anniversary box.
Well, how? Who?
I don't know. And it was addressed to me. And it had a hat and a mug. And it had like a replica of the ring. And we have a friend who actually is a huge Lord of the Rings fan. So we're going to give him the ring. But no, it's not. He knows that he knows where it came from. It's not like a
right,
gift.
Right, right, right. It's not a regifting. He knows about the regifting, rather.
Exactly. This is an open regifting. But the mug is really nice, actually. I've been using it for the last couple of days. So
great.
Now's a great time to jump back into that game then for you.
Yeah, so Lord of the Rings Online. You should play it if you like Lord of the Rings and online.
And mugs. If you like mugs.
Mugs. I do like mugs very much. I have a mug problem, but that's a whole other conversation. And Shanafig Keg has to say, Wombat is correct. Zack Snyder's Dawn of the Dead remake is actually really good. So that'll lead us right into Watch This, Bitches. But yeah, if you haven't seen that movie, you should. It's unlike any other movie Zack Snyder's made, and it makes you wonder what could have been.
Okay.
So, mm-hmm.
So Watch This, Bitches. I got two things to report on. I finished the HBO series Big Little Lies, and it was fantastic.
Talked about it briefly last week.
Yeah, I had only watched maybe one or two episodes by then, but we finished the 7 episodes in the season. It was great. I really was impressed by the acting. It's hard to even – someone's winning an award for that performance, for their performance. It's either going to be Nicole Kidman or – man, everybody was really good in it. It's hard to even – to pick, but it's a great thriller. I don't think Shipwreck is going to watch it.
Nope.
And I don't think Wombat's going to watch it either, actually.
I've watched about half of John Wick in my watching movies in the middle of the night.
This is not like John Wick.
John Wick's pretty good. People were right. That movie's pretty good.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's a fun movie.
So far. It's got the guy from the Mayhem insurance commercials in it.
Yes, it does.
That's
30
the moment
Rock.
Where everybody has watched John Wick, I'm sure, pointed at the screen and went, hey, it's that guy.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know he did anything besides those commercials.
I think he only has like one hand or something weird, though. Like in real life.
Okay.
So try to pay attention to see if you could see both of his hands at any point.
Hmm. All right. I'm not going to do that, probably.
Like Radar from MASH.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
The other show that I started watching is Into the Badlands, which I guess maybe is new on Netflix. It's a martial arts show, basically. A martial arts adventure that takes place in, I don't know, in the future, I guess. I'm not even sure what the time frame is, though, but I've only seen one episode so far. But the kung fu scenes in the movie are as good as anything that I've ever seen in a movie or anywhere. Top notch. No, it seems like no expense was spared. Better, you know, far better than anything that's in Iron Fist. And the story is interesting too, at least in the first episode. So that, I think, Shipwreck, you could get into. Does that sound appealing to you?
It doesn't sound not appealing.
There's
it
no
doesn't
like
sound super depressing.
No, there doesn't seem to be any heavy issues in it. I mean, really, the action is unbelievable.
This is a TV show?
This is a TV show. It was on AMC and it's on Netflix now. If you want to grab it.
How much time do I have to invest into this? That's my big problem with the TV shows.
They're hour episodes, so on Netflix without the commercials, they're I guess 45 minutes. It's good shit, man. It's good shit, at least so far. So yeah, into the Badlands. What else we got here?
I saw a movie over the weekend on Earth Day. I saw Disney's Born in China, Disney Nature's Born in China, with the boy. We enjoyed it. It has panda bears in it.
Is this like a very short movie?
It's like an hour and 20 minutes. So
that's good length.
Yeah, it's a good length. I've never seen actually one of these nature movies on a big screen before. So that was kind of a cool experience. It's all like these, you know, nice wide cinematographic. Is that a word?
Cinema fantastic, I think is the word you're
looking
for.
Views of China and mountains and forests. And it's got pandas and monkeys and a snow leopard. And it's cool. You know, if you like animal shows, which I'm pretty big into, it's one of the three things I watch. Shows about food, shows about animals, and shows with superheroes in it. That's pretty much the list. So it was really cool, and Elliot and I both really liked it. Elliot is now obsessed with snow leopards ever since we saw it. So, you know, I guess mission accomplished. I don't know. But
this
no,
is what
really,
you went to instead of going to the Long Island Retro 80s night event.
Yes. Well, it's the same. I played those games there.
It's totally different now.
All right. If you say so.
They have consoles now. Classic consoles.
Yeah, they had that last time I was there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Do they have karaoke?
No, they didn't, but that's okay.
Do they have a bar?
No, they didn't have a bar.
It's a really good turnout, actually. I was impressed.
I'm not surprised.
And by the way, you can come see a live CADcast this summer at the Long Island Retro Gaming Expo, August 12th and 13th. But our thing's going to be on the 12th. I think they're going to have a really good turnout because there was a very nice turnout for this thing on Saturday night. Yeah, I was pretty impressed with the turnout. Hmm. And Ty blew up the Death Star in Star Wars while using the Force. Got that Force bonus.
Hmm.
You know?
Hmm.
Hmm. All right. Let's do some new releases.
Sure.
Fantastic.
Good luck finding ones that we're able to talk about in an educated way.
Chip, are you getting Mario Kart 8 Deluxe?
I guess I have to. Like that's the law if you own a Switch, right?
I'm gonna get it.
The Switch has some fantastic games from 2014 coming out this week.
Yeah.
You can pick up Puyo Puyo Tetris and Mario Kart 8. Both are fantastic games.
What's good about Puyo Puyo Tetris?
It's a really fun puzzle game.
How does that differ from regular Tetris?
It's also got Puyo Puyo in there.
I'm not familiar with Puyo Puyo.
Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine.
I don't know what
that do anything for you?
No.
I'm forgetting what the other game is that this is called. It's the little globs. You get two colored globs. They're falling down. It's kind of like Dr. Mario as well.
Okay.
That's essentially what Puyo Puyo is.
We played that at Long Island Retro. on Saturday.
Okay. Yeah. So it's both of those games. I imported this for Xbox One back in 2014, I think.
Nice.
So it's finally hitting the States. That's also coming or is out. I don't remember, but it's coming out for the other consoles as well. And it's $10 cheaper for the other consoles, I believe. Yeah, it's $30 on PlayStation 4 and $40 on Nintendo Switch.
Sweet. That Switch tax right there.
Mm-hmm.
But no, I'm going to get Mario Kart. I think that'd be
Mario
fun.
Mario Kart's, it's a great game. I didn't play an overwhelming amount of it on the Wii U. So I guess I'll buy it again. I feel like I'll play it more.
I feel like I could play that with my family because I'm not going to be super good at it because I don't know. The last time I played Mario Kart was, I don't know, on a Super Nintendo maybe. So it's been a while. So I don't really have any skills, so I won't probably dominate. But I would need to buy another controller, I guess. It's expensive. It's an expensive proposition, this Switch. If I can even find a pro controller.
I see them pretty regularly around here.
Oh, okay.
For whatever that's worth. Probably harder to find in New York.
Hmm. Well, I guess that's out on Friday, right?
That is out on Friday. And if you go to Target, you can see all of their Mario Kart decorations.
Probably get it at Best Buy for that 20% off.
But not as much Mario Kart decorations.
That's fine. Less moving. Mm-hmm. What else we got?
We also have, what else do we have? Felt like there was more than that.
Wow.
I know the Shovel Knight new content is up.
That's out for PlayStation 4 now.
I believe it's free if you own the game already. So, I don't know. If you own the game already, there's new Shovel Knight content for you.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
So that's cool. Mm-hmm. Sniper Ghost Warrior 3.
I watched the trailer for that. It seemed like it could be good, but it also...
I'll let you know probably next week.
Oh, look at you. I'm looking on Metacritic right now. I can't wait. 54%.
Yeah, it doesn't have great reviews, so... What can you do?
So is this just your genre now? Is these sniper
I do like those sniper games a lot. I'm sorry I have a game. I'm sorry I like those games.
No,
I'm apologizing.
Obviously
you're offended by it.
I'm not offended in any way. I knew you liked the other sniper game.
I do like Sniper Elite a lot. So that's why I'm sort of interested in this one. I don't think I've played any of these, so
I'd like to float a theory about why you like these games.
I think I know the theory, but go ahead.
Would you like to guess the theory first? I don't think you're going to get it, though.
Because they're slow and you don't have to move?
Yep.
Yeah. I don't think it's a secret.
Okay. Yeah, you don't have to master the whole moving while shooting scenario. Not that I have, but... Okay, that's fine. What else we got? What else we got this week? Besides Booty
Diver.
For the
3DS cheapy, we have Ping Pong Trick Shot 2.
There you go, and it's $2.
Yeah, it looked like it should be, it's overpriced, basically. Looks like hot garbage. So does Booty Diver for the Wii U.
I don't think there's a price high enough for Booty Diver.
I thought it was Booty Driver. And so I was like, wow, Booty Driver. And then I started Googling it, and of course I didn't find anything. But yeah, it's Booty Diver. Also, it looks like it's overpriced. But I don't know. Whatever. What else we got?
That might be it. It feels like
I think that's more.
Yeah. But I might just be thinking about the 20 games that Wombat got this week.
Right. It's messing us all up. All right. Well, now it's time to talk about Harry's. Wombat's favorite item to regift to friends and family.
You know what? Everyone who gets that pack falls in love with it. And you can get one for free, too. So if you're listening and you want the official Wombat Happy Wedding Father's Day Birthday Gift Pack, Mm-hmm. All you need to do to get this set for free, all you need to do is cover the shipping, which is $3, which is, you know, what's $3? Nothing. And your free trial set includes the weighted ergonomic razor handle, the 5 precision engineered blades with lubricating strip and trimmer blade, rich lathering shave gel, and a travel blade cover. That's a $13 value. It's a $13 value for you to try. It is awesome. So stop messing around and get started shaving today with Harry's by claiming your free trial offer. That's a $13 value for free. Just cover shipping. To get your free trial set, including a razor handle, 5-blade cartridge, and shave gel, go to harrys.com/cadcast right now. That's harrys.com/cadcast.
Yeah, it's really
good.
Alternatively,
if you would like a free set, you could also invite Wombat to something where he feels obligated to bring you a gift.
That's another way.
Preferably a bachelor party. That's where it really fits in. No, but I mean, the Harry stuff is really good. I really am a big fan of the aftershave gel, post-shave balm, I think is what they call it.
Yes.
But I'm all about that. I cover my entire head with that after I'm done shaving. The blades are also great, really sharp. They stay sharp. And I really like the little nose trimmer that's on the top of the blade. Nose hair trimmer. Not nose hair trimmer, like mustache trimmer. I just revealed my hand that I do use it to trim my nose hairs. But it works for that too. Anyway, harrys.com/cadcast. I've never heard any complaints from any of our listeners who have ordered it. Not a single complaint. So what does that say? And you know, people like to complain. Must mean it's good. And it is.
Yeah.
Thank you, Harry's. Now it's time for multi-platforming and Wombat's Overwatch Onslaught and also other video game news and stuff. Well, there is some big Overwatch news this week, Wombat. Are you on top of it?
They released Heroes of the Storm something something?
Exactly. So Heroes of the Storm is Blizzard's MOBA game.
Let's say their other game?
No, they have, what do you mean? No, their other game is Hearthstone and Diablo.
And Diablo. There was a big StarCraft. Diablo update that I haven't checked out yet, but it's supposed to be pretty good.
But basically, if you play 5 games of Heroes of the Storm with somebody on your friends list, you will unlock various items for Overwatch, including a really cool Genji skin and a really cool... The Genji skin is a Oni Genji.
I had Genji skin, but I went to the doctor and he gave me an ointment.
Yes. If you use Harry's post-shave bomb, that eliminates the Genji skin.
That'll get rid of your Genji skin. Yeah,
totally.
Yes. Right click.
I really want the Officer Diva skin. Have you seen that? It's pretty...
I did because you tweeted it out.
I like it. I want it. Mm-hmm. But the question is, do I want it enough to play 5 games of Heroes of the Storm? And that I don't have quite an answer for. Probably not, I'm thinking. But just in case, I did install the game.
Now, is this a PC-only thing, though? Like,
correct.
You only get the skin for the PC version?
No, no. If you're linked, it'll get it on your PC, on PC and any consoles you have linked to your
So, if you don't have a PC that can play Heroes of the Storm, and you're only a console player of Overwatch, you're kind of shit out of luck.
I believe that they're going to be throwing these skins into the general loot box.
Because that's kind of crappy.
No, I just told you.
Considering that it's Overwatch, crappy is sort of my expectation.
I just told you they're going to be throwing it into the general population so you can win it in a loot box or, I guess, unlock it with your in-game currency at some point. I don't know. But I do want the office, the Diva skin. It looks pretty sweet. What else we got here? I see a lot of things on here.
I've been playing a game called Skitties. I'm sorry. I can't.
Skittles?
I can't talk. Cities. I have been playing Cities on the Xbox One.
Okay.
Have you been playing that at all, Ship?
I know of this game. This is the PC game.
Yeah. Yeah. It was on PC. They just released it for Xbox One.
It's SimCity.
It is SimCity. Yes.
City Skylines. Isn't that the name of the game?
Skylines. Yes. That's what I was trying to say when I said Skitties.
I like Skitties.
Yes.
They could save a lot of time.
I know.
Just call
it Skitties. It's a lot of fun. I actually was playing that right before we were doing the show. More of it. I've been playing. It's cool because you could play, you know, for real, or you could play with unlimited cash and not have to, like, worry about anything, and you could just kind of build. And Elliot is really into that. So it's kind of cool to have a game that I can play with my son, because he's really not old enough to play most games.
Right.
And it's kind of cool because he learns things, too, like, you know, where you should put residential areas and business areas and industry and how plumbing works. So
he's learned how plumbing works.
Yeah.
The poop goes here when I make this pipe.
Pretty much. Well, because if you have, and I learned this the hard way, because I wasn't paying attention and I didn't realize the game was going to be that, you know, in depth, where you have to watch the current of the water, because if you put your intake for water on the wrong side of the outtake for water, everyone in your town is going to get diarrhea. And guess what? Everyone in my town got diarrhea, and everyone was getting sick all the time, and I couldn't figure out why. So I just kept building more hospitals instead of fixing the problem.
You thought it was just like an epidemic going around.
Yeah, I just thought, oh, in the game, I guess people get sick. And it turns out it's because I had poop water flowing through all the faucets. Basically, I built Flint, Michigan. And so I had to shut down my water intake and built a new one on the right side. And no one got sick anymore. So there you go. I learned something.
Right.
Don't drink poop water.
And don't eat at Domino's.
There you go. So there you go. That's that.
What else are you playing?
No, I didn't put that one on there.
Have you not played any ukulele yet?
Not yet. I played, what is it, Punch Club, which is very funny and enjoyable so far.
Mm-hmm. We've talked about Punch Club before.
Have you? Okay. I didn't realize you had talked. Yeah. It's got a nice bunch of 80s references in there. And that's a cute game. I played some 88 Heroes. Which is also, you know, it's also a cute game. I like that one, actually. I only played like 45 minutes of it, though, so I need...
That's all you're ever going to play that.
No, I'll play more of it, because I like it.
Let me know when you get to the obnoxious games. Let me know when you get to the obnoxious indie games, the pretentious ones.
Yeah, no, I haven't played any of the pretentious ones. I played a little bit of Race the Sun, which I had played before, and I know I like that game. So, you know, that was fun. And,
So are you
going to
play ukulele at all?
Yeah, no. Sabrina very much wants to play it. I only got the game last night at like 10, and I didn't get home tonight until 7:30. And we're recording a show now. Okay. Give me a chance.
Give Wombat a chance.
I finally finished it. It took me, I think 27 or 28 hours.
Holy moly!
And that was only to get like barely over the mandatory number of collectibles to fight the final boss. Like, there's still about a third of the collectibles to go if I really wanted to go at it.
That seems like a gigantic game for that genre.
It is. Like, they spent a long time working on this game.
Am I going to like it or am I going to hate it?
Do you want to play a N64 style platformer?
I mean, I like N64 style platformers.
Do you want to play an N64 style platformer?
I don't know. There's part of me that, because I have Voodoo Vince now, and I never played that.
That's not an N64 style platformer.
I know, but I've played Banjo-Kazooie. So it's, do I want to play a game that's a successor, you know, that's an N64 style platformer, or do I want to play a game like Voodoo Vince that I never played the first time around?
That's an original Xbox style platformer.
Exactly. So it's like six in one hand, half dozen in the other. So I have to figure out what I want to do there. But both of them are
good platforming games.
Oh, and I also played...
Is not super long, so you could get through that one.
What's the game called? Is it Flint Hook? Is that the name of the game?
Flint Hook, yep.
Yeah, that game is good too. That's a fun game. You would like that, Shipwreck.
I do like that.
Yeah. Oh, you have it?
Yep.
Oh, see? Flint Hook, good game. I was right. Shipwreck would like it. So that's a fun little platformer puzzle, old school almost Nintendo Entertainment style game. So maybe more Super Nintendo style game. So there you go. I've been playing those games in a short amount of time. I've gone through a lot of them. I've also been playing Marvel Heroes Omega on the PlayStation 4.
I have as well.
I've been playing as Iron Man mostly. because
I've been playing as Spider-Man.
And I like it. Having played, what's the other one? DC Universe, as far as MMOs based on superhero licenses go. This one is, I like playing as an actual superhero maybe a little bit more than playing as the creator character.
Of course. But, of course you do.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Isn't this more like Ultimate Alliance?
It plays a lot like Ultimate Alliance. So far, I haven't.
To an extent.
It has a little bit of MMO
game.
There's some grinding, MMO style grinding. And there's, you know, the tasks are very MMO like. You know, go collect 6 of these and beat up 8 of these kind of a thing. So.
How does it differ?
This is a free to play game, right? I know you got codes that had a whole bunch of characters unlocked or whatever.
It's free to play. The characters can be unlocked with points that you can acquire within the game, or you can buy characters up front.
There was a lot of currencies going on.
Yeah.
Within the first hour of me playing this game, like, there kept on being screens pop up that would like tell me stuff that seemed way too complicated. As far as like how to buy stuff or unlock stuff. Maybe it makes more sense as you play through it more, but the game itself is okay. It's in beta, I guess, still, because it says beta when I boot it up.
Yeah, but I think it doesn't officially come out for like another month.
It's still got some jank in there. You can tell this is a free-to-play game. Like the animations and overall the graphics aren't that great. I feel like I'm getting enough enjoyment out of playing it because it's Marvel licensed. But say if this was a license I did not care about, if this was a DC game like this, I would not give it a second thought.
Yeah, and I think that's sort of the hook. I mean, that's really the appeal. The appeal is all the different Marvel characters, and there's a lot of different characters in it. So
Squirrel Girl is in there.
Squirrel Girl is in there. Kitty Pryde is in there, which made Sabrina very happy. That's her favorite Marvel character.
Have you tried unlocking any of these people yet?
I haven't because, I mean, there's enough I have enough characters already that I didn't. But I also kind of have been sticking with Iron Man. That's the other thing with a game like this, though. It's like, I can get Iron Man up to level 50, and he's already at level 4. I don't know if I want to go and switch to a level 1 character where I am.
It said something, like one of the pop-ups said something about you could play any character to level 10 or something, too?
Yeah, you could play any character for free up to level 10. Okay. So if you're not sure if you want to bite the bullet on...
I think my confusion is just because I have so much, like, that was given to us review-wise.
Mm-hmm.
Like, review code-wise, that it further muddies the water on how the mechanics of the game work.
Yeah, so you could try any character you don't own up to level 10, which is good, because then you could decide... if you want to actually spend either your in-game currency or real currency on it after really almost an hour or more of playing with them. So it's not a bad idea, you know, and it's not as nickel and dimey for a game that is very nickel and dimey. So
it does have a couch co-op, right?
It does have couch co-op, which I think is new for consoles.
Yeah,
so,
it is.
Yeah, you can play it with Ty.
I'm thinking about it.
Did you try that at all? Is it split screen or is it just everybody's on the same screen? Because it's...
I don't know.
It's isometric, so I would hope that everybody's just on the same
screen. I would be surprised. Yeah, it could be that also that thing where if you go too far apart, it turns into split screen, but if you're together, it's one screen.
We'll check it out. We'll get back to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me know. You have all the same stuff that Shipwreck and I have. You could be... I don't know, Hawkeye and the Hulk? That sounds like a good team up. I'd watch that.
I wouldn't be Hawkeye. What do you think I am, a freak?
I played as Hawkeye for a little bit.
I rest my case.
I like Hawkeye.
I rest my case
again.
In
the tutorial, the last person you play as is Hulk.
Yeah.
And like, I am a little bit confused at why anybody would play like as anybody other than Hulk if they actually wanted to like just plow through the game.
Well, because
he was just like wiping out these guys that.
Yeah, because you want to play as your favorite Marvel character. That's why.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why.
It's not about winning, Ship. It's about fan service and making your dreams come true.
Yeah, Exactly. Oh, I'm going to be Spider-Man, and boom, you're Spider-Man.
I defeated the human laser.
I did that. Yes, I did that as
I'm not familiar with that character.
Oh, really? Oh, he's been around for a while. An Avengers villain, I believe.
Prominent enough to be the first boss you fight.
He's the shocker of this game.
Right.
So, you know, nothing wrong with that. Please, I noticed they mentioned the wizard as one of the main villains. So, what can you do?
Let's see. So, Call of Duty World War II was revealed. Not revealed, but they had a marketing push today where they... I don't know. I didn't watch it.
And yes, Living Laser's first appearance was Avengers 34 in 1966.
I thought he was the human laser. Is he the Living Laser?
Living Laser.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anybody watch Call of Duty World War II trailer? I watched the trailer. I didn't watch the live stream.
Was it just a no gameplay trailer?
No.
Cinematic?
I don't know, actually. That's a good question. I watched it, and I don't even know the answer. I watched it on my iPhone while I was eating lunch, so I didn't really have all my attention.
I feel like it's still too early for me to care yet. I'm not saying
I won't
care.
Come on. You're going to get it.
I know. I said it. Not saying I'm not going to care later. I'm saying right now I don't care.
You'll play the single player through and be impressed with its graphical fidelity and sound design.
And I'll enjoy it the same as I've enjoyed the last... four Call of Duties that I've played. So what do you want from me?
You'll no doubt
skip this one. I don't have any interest in World War II games.
Well, see, I have more interest in World War II. Maybe, you know.
That's fine.
Different strokes. Yeah.
I feel like I've done enough of that. And I don't know. Hmm.
Is it the lack of diversity?
In weapons?
I would say. Whatever. Choose.
I don't know. It just doesn't. It always. The World War II ones, they've started feeling really heavy handed story wise. And that's all fine and well. And I've played enough of them now that I know what I'm getting story wise. And
I think what you may see in this one is probably, if this is my guess, is going to be some. Extreme,
wacky? Is it going to be
extreme
wacky?
Graphic violence, I think, is mm-hmm. what you're going to get.
And big set pieces. But, you know, World War II set pieces are probably pretty intense and fun to play.
I think you're going to see heads caved in, Saving Private Ryan style, and it's going to be gross. And I think people are going to be very impressed by that, which might be even weirder.
I think I'm good on World War II.
What if I told you?
I tried to play that Battlefield game.
That was just bad. That was just not a good. At least the part that we played, it was really annoying, and it didn't have any big set pieces. You know, you storm in the beaches.
It wasn't
of Normandy.
That World War One.
It was World War One, but it's
very different.
I give it to you that it's different, but it's not. It's got. It feels the same.
It's not different enough.
Yeah.
I understand. I understand what you're saying.
I played the good.
You don't
World
like
War II
Jews.
Games.
We get
I played,
it.
I
you don't
want to
free
War
the
II
Jews.
Games.
We understand. You don't have to keep hammering it home.
I already did it.
Shipwreck. Let my people go.
I did.
I mean, really.
Like 7 times last generation, at least.
Thank you. We appreciate your service.
Right.
All right. I'm going to get it, especially with the $10 reward certificate at Best Buy. Not going to get it.
I might get it. I don't know.
Yeah,
you're going to get it. We all know you are.
I don't know that I am. I really don't, because I like laser guns.
You're going to get a Scorpio, and you're going to see how good the game's going to look on a Scorpio, and you're probably going to get it for that.
I just feel like I have so many like memories of all the other Call of Duty World War II games.
You're going to talk about how you vomited when someone lost a head in this game.
That doesn't bother me.
I thought that kind of stuff bothered you in real life.
In real life, it would. No.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's going to be like, it's going to look so real.
Who wouldn't it bother in real life?
These people, though, in this game.
Don't care.
I don't know.
They'll make you care.
No, they won't. They haven't made me care for a long time.
Well, didn't you like the last one?
I did. I like space.
Space is good.
I like space and robots, and spaceships, yeah, and lasers.
Wisecracking robots are the best.
And grenades that walk around like spiders.
Yeah, that was
that's
fun.
All. That's all like fun entertainment for me. Like World War II was not fun entertainment for me.
No, I will. Yeah, I mean the thing about the game that came out that was it Infinite Warfare, is that but the setting you can kind of it could just be straight ahead fun and nothing serious about it. Whereas if you're doing something based on...
The story was serious still. Like,
yes, the story was still serious, but it, you know, you didn't have, it didn't have to be reverent.
Right, right, exactly.
So
it's the same reason I don't watch, like, depressing documentaries.
Yeah, I don't watch those either. Although I am watching a World War II documentary right now. I'm watching Five Came Home, is that what it's called?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm watching that on Netflix. It's very good. You should watch it.
No.
Steven Spielberg and Guillermo del Toro and lots of others.
Let's see. So a new game coming out called Danger Zone, which is inspired by the Crash Mode in Burnout Paradise 3. No, Burnout 3.
No, Burnout.
Burnout 3. They haven't had Crash Modes in a long time.
That's coming out. It's coming out next month.
Yeah, soon. I hope it's good.
It's going to be $13 and... yeah, I did enjoy Crash Mode. So I'm...
Oh, it was great.
Yeah.
I mean, and then they tried to do it with that 2D version, or the overhead version, I guess.
And it wasn't nearly as good.
It was still fun, but it
wasn't the same.
It wasn't the same game. No, it was more of a puzzle. Well, they're both kind of puzzle games.
Yeah. The screenshots of this look pretty realistic.
But does it look like Forza Hot Wheels?
That I'm pretty excited about.
That looks pretty rad.
I showed that to Ty, and he's like, "We're getting that, right? Right?" I was like, "Yeah, we will be getting that."
I'm going to have to get that. I think my son's going to explode when he sees that.
And then he's like, "Oh, that's the Bone Crusher," or so I forgot what the car was called, but he actually recognized the names of the cars that they were showing.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
I didn't even know that people knew those things, but okay.
You would be shocked, because some mornings when I don't want to really go to work right away, I will go into Kmart and just look for, you know, the occasional Hot Wheel Batmobile.
Right.
But if you go in there at the right time, you'll see there's a crowd of grown men who pour through the Hot Wheels looking for rare ones.
That's you. You're one of these.
I'm not that bad. I go in, if they'll have a Batmobile.
You have a bulletin board full of these
at
your office at work.
Oh, they go and they find these ones that they're crazy people. I'm not a crazy person.
Ship, the difference is that these guys only go there, they know when the Hot Wheels get refreshed, I think. And Wombat just goes every day, so he doesn't have to really care about when it gets refreshed or not.
I'll usually stop in like once a week, but that's okay.
Right. Me too. I honestly do the same thing. When you're waiting for the train in Penn Station, you don't have a lot of options to entertain yourself. You can...
Exactly.
you can go to Subway or you can go to Kmart. That's
so I usually go to Kmart. Yeah, and there's no Toys R Us anymore by me in the city, which is sad. So it's my only outlet.
So are you going to be able to use just like the normal Forza cars in this as well?
Yes. Yeah. According to the trailer, you can.
But, you know, Fantastic. Hot Wheel cars.
I know.
That's kind of cool.
I'm excited.
I'm excited about the tracks. Hot Wheel cars just don't, like, I don't know. Doesn't really do much for me.
No, but the tracks are going to be cool. Loops.
Yeah, the tracks sound great. I get the appeal of the Hot Wheels cars for kids, but I would rather just use the other cars, I think.
Sure. We understand. You're dead inside. We get it.
I am a little bit when it comes to Hot Wheels. Unless, like, the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile is in there, I will drive around as that.
I think it's only a matter of time. That should be free DLC, sponsored by Oscar Mayer.
Get the Batmobile.
Did you get your Lunchable avatar props, Wombat?
I haven't. Not yet.
Get on that.
I will.
Let's talk about Nintendo.
Okay. I got something from Nintendo today.
Oh, yeah?
I went to McDonald's and got a Happy Meal. They have Nintendo toys. I got Yoshi. He sticks his tongue in and out weirdly.
Did you just throw the food out, or did you actually eat it?
Oh no, I enjoy McDonald's food.
Oh really?
Yeah.
They let you buy a Happy Meal as a grown man?
Yes, there are no rules against that.
Okay.
Yeah, no, they've never been,
right?
No, nope.
I don't think so.
I thought it was a law, actually.
No, it's definitely not a law.
No.
I don't know what country you live in, but no, it's never been a law. It's because I know a lot of people that do that because it's really a Happy Meal at McDonald's is sort of like a normal serving. So.
Yeah, it's a lot smaller. It's really the fries is what. The fries and the drink, you get like servings that aren't going to
kill you.
Japan sizes, we call them.
Yes.
Probably a little smaller. At least the fries are. Mm-hmm.
They're pretty small.
Yeah.
But then you also get apple slices, so it evens out.
Mm. Or a clementine.
Very responsible. I go with the apple slices. McDonald's. Mm-hmm. Here's some questions about Nintendo. At Gaming Dad writes in and asks, what are the chances that Nintendo releases the NES Classic digitally as a game for the Switch? The price point is right there. What is he saying? Like, it's going to be, they're going to charge you $60 for a pack?
For a pack of 30 NES? I don't see that happening.
That sounds too cheap for Nintendo.
Yep.
So they're probably not going to do that. They want to charge you $5 each.
I think there's zero chance of that. I mean, it sounds like a great idea. I would definitely buy that if they did it.
Yes.
Even though I already have an NES Mini here and I already have most of those games.
But you'd be able to play those games on the go, and that might be worth it.
Right.
I understand.
So to answer his question, the chance is slim and none.
But what if they did it in... packs of 10 for $20 each or $25 each. 3 10 packs at $25 each.
It's too cheap for them.
$75 for 30 games.
Still too cheap for them. They want to probably get like $5 a game is what I'm thinking.
It's amazing to me that there's still no virtual console on the Switch.
Right. It's or app. Is there online play yet?
No.
Cool.
Well, online play, there's going to have to be, right? For Mario Kart?
Does that mean the app is coming out soon? Is the app out? I don't even know. The app.
I feel like if the app was out, we would have seen a lot about it.
I guess.
Are they launching Mario Kart without the online?
I don't know.
No, they can't be doing that, right?
That seems weird. Somebody get back to us on that. Well, it's coming out soon. We'll find out.
Woohoo.
At Retro Amigo writes in and he asks, am I the only customer upset that after being unable to buy an NES Mini, they're now talking about an SNES Mini I'll also never be able to buy? No, I think a lot of people are upset about that. But that's still just a rumor, right? That hasn't been confirmed yet. That's a thing coming out.
Yeah.
Do you think... Okay, Wombat, you're the great... prognosticator. Are they gonna make an SNES Mini? I mean,
talked about this. I think that the only way that they're going to release one is if they've already started producing one.
Oh yeah, I forgot that's right. Yeah. I like that theory. Okay. Mm-hmm. we'll see. Bickle writes in and he says, top analyst challenge. When will Nintendo release a second revision of the Switch that will fix most of the design issues and introduce one minor issue that we will live with? I feel like the next version of the Switch...
Two years.
I think it's next summer.
It's close to 2 years. It's a year and a half.
With a smaller bezel. It'll be a little smaller, but the screen size will be the same. It'll be less bezel... And maybe the controllers don't come off?
I think it's a little bit soon for that. They might put out a version like that, but I think they're pretty committed to buying all those other controllers for it.
Right. They are priced pretty high, and they probably make some good coin off that. Yeah, that's a good point. But I feel like that version is coming at some point as a portable, as a replacement for the 3DS.
Yeah, I think later on down the road, I think that could
maybe 2 years.
I think once the development for the motion control type stuff slows.
I'm sure that's happened already.
Right. I mean, ARMS is going to come out, and if ARMS is what the universe wants and they want to play it with the motion controls, then Nintendo might make a whole bunch of those type games.
I'm just going to say that that's not going to happen, that people don't want that. Because I know Splatoon has motion controls, and I remember seeing on Twitter people are like, how do I turn off the motion controls?
Oh, I turned them off in Zelda. I know that. But yeah, I the NPDs came out for Nintendo since the last time we talked, right?
Oh, I do not have them here.
I don't either, but I know that the attach ratio is basically 1-for-1 on Zelda and Switches.
Yeah, well,
yes.
What else are you going to buy?
And the number 2 selling game was 1-2 Switch.
Right.
So, welcome aboard third parties.
Right.
Woohoo.
And goodbye third parties.
Mm-hmm. Here's the door.
I want to give a shout out again to Horizon Zero Dawn. I started playing that again. The story is actually really good.
I finished it.
No, I'm at the end. I'm like at the last 6 missions or so.
I understand that because that's where I am with Mass Effect. But go on.
It's long. I just want to say that the story is getting really good. It seems really well done. I just learned what Horizon Zero Dawn is. And it's very cool. It seems like it could be right out of a major motion picture or a well-written novel. And yeah, I'm just into the story now, which is cool. And of course the game is awesome anyway, but yeah, it's definitely one of my favorite games for the last 12 months or so. Just wanted to throw that out there.
I finished the relationship mission in, you know, the consummating a relationship in...
you got laid, is what you're saying.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
How'd that go?
But now it's like a committed relationship. The difference in Andromeda is that you can start boning chicks before you're, like, committed to someone.
And then you can't.
Now... Huh?
And then once you get committed, you can't bone anyone else different?
Yeah, exactly. Then you're stuck with one lady. You know, kind of like life.
Right.
So, I did that. I made a commitment.
Did you, an alien or a human?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You see any nudity?
Not yet. I think there's something, but I don't know. I may not have gotten that far yet.
Fifth base?
Yes, fifth base with the alien lady, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't know. What else have we got here? Cagbang? Did I skip
You only mine? Have one thing on here.
I know. There wasn't a lot of comments this week. I guess it's a slow week or something.
It is a slow week.
Not a lot of questions. At Crow2K writes in and says, so buying a PS4 Pro or Scorpio is now going to be like an Apple or Android cell. So does next year... Does PS4 Pro Plus come out to leapfrog Scorpio?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
All right. I'm glad we came to that conclusion.
I think...
Ship, any opinions?
Seems a little early.
All right.
I don't think that there's really much value at that point. I think now, even at the PS4 Pro level, I don't know how much better is Scorpio going to look than a PS4 Pro game. I don't think it's going to be really that much noticeable.
All the games are still going to be programmed for the base versions of these,
mm-hmm.
which already look great, and they are especially on 1080p TVs, which is what most people are playing on. So I don't know. Maybe they might come out with a PS4 Pro Slim.
Right. That could be. I don't know
that'll push some units.
I'm not sure like the difference between like 1440p or whatever the PS4 Pro is doing, whatever comes between 1440p and 4K and actual 4K, native 4K. I don't know if the difference is going to be that big or noticeable to a lot of people. I mean, yeah, the 60 frames per second versus 30 frames per second, okay, that's significant, but I don't think it's worth it for Sony to go and engineer something just to say that theirs is the most powerful now.
Well, Sony does what they can do, though. So maybe.
Like, you think they might do something? They don't. I mean, it would be
a company works. Like they go after technology that they're capable of doing, and then they see if there's a market after they do that.
Right. I mean, it is
the way people are buying PS4s. There's a market there.
Might as well. It is really solely like a marketing thing at this point, even for Microsoft. Mm-hmm. But hey, it might be effective. I mean, it's not like they're going to start outselling, you know, overtaking PS4 worldwide, but it could give them a little bump, give them something to run commercials on. Anyway, I think that's it for the show. I'm tired.
All right.
I want to remind everybody to follow us on Twitter at GPD, at New Wombat, at Shipwreck, at Video Game Deals. And to go to harrys.com/cadcast to get your trial set for just $3 shipping. harrys.com/cadcast. And that's it.
Brent's done.
Mother's Day is here. You know, the R. Carvel store owners are just so great. For Mother's Day, they have the most beautiful custom-made Carvel ice cream flower basket that you've ever seen. Now, you go to your participating Carvel ice cream deal, and you just watch him make the ice cream right in the store. They will custom inscribe it for Mom. Now, would you like to send a Mother's Day cake? Please call the toll-free number that you see listed here, and we honor most major credit cards. Thank you.